Hey guys, welcome back. It's your girl Toya T, and I'm back in my car again. This month is just so crazy for me. It's my birthday month, and I seem to be running around all over the place trying to get a lot of stuff done. So I'm making another video in my car while I'm driving. Anyway, since today is Wednesday, it's a whatever day for me. So it's a miscellaneous day, so I decided to do a Toya's Tips Day. And this one is about how to deal with rejection in all sense of the word. And I think these last 2 days, I've felt all kinds of rejection. And it's all about figuring out how to deal with it. So even if it's rejection from someone that maybe you like or you'd like to date and they don't want, you know, that kind of relationship with you, or maybe it's a friend that you would like to remain close to, but they decided that, you know, maybe your friendship is not something that's good for them, so they decided to end it or have distanced themselves from you. Or maybe it's that job or that postdoc or that fellowship that you wanted, that you got really close to, but you just didn't get, and someone else got it. So I've experienced all of these things that I just mentioned in the last 2 days. So I can say in the last 24 hours. You know, it's about figuring out how do you keep moving from there. And for me, you know, usually as I think I mentioned before, I don't do well with change. So that's the thing that throws me off the most. And rejection is also a part of that too. So when I have something, when I get my mind on something, I kind of just go full throttle with it. I'm very passionate about things. I'm a true Cancer. Like once I'm very passionate about a lot of things. I'm very loyal. So when people decide, when friendships end or relationships with people end, I take it to heart, because I don't let that too many people in. So when, you know, when a relationship with somebody changes, it just throws me off, and I dwell on it, and it, you know, I cry for maybe a day and get upset about it. But it's all about moving forward, and sometimes things happen for a reason. I truly believe that you know, all things happen for a reason, and you just have to figure out what that reason is. So maybe if that happens to you, you know, maybe this person is out of your life so that another person can come in, or because, you know, down the road they're probably going to cause you more, you know, they're going to cause you pain or heartbreak or something. So, you know, you always have to see something. So as my mom always says, you always got to see the silver lining in every cloud. So if you've ever experienced that, that's what I would say to you. Figure out, like, you know, if you feel like you need to cry, cry. Like, there is nothing wrong if someone, if something happens, relationship-wise or whatever, and if you feel hurt and you feel like you need to cry, go ahead and cry. Cry it out. Cry until it's done. You know, there's always an end to your crying. Trust me. So if you feel like you need to cry for a full hour or for a full day or for 2 hours or for whatever, go ahead and do that. Go ahead and do that until you get it all out. It's never good for you to keep, you know, your emotions bottled up. If you're at work and this thing happens, go to the bathroom and cry for as long as you can in that bathroom or wherever it is. Or in my case, cry in your car for like a good 2 hours. And then get over it. You move on, you focus on the next thing, and you move on to the next thing. And the same thing about rejection for a job or a position that you really wanted. In my case, I'm trying to move, shift careers, and I was really close. I was a finalist for this job, and I just didn't get it. And I got the email last night, but I didn't see it until this morning. So I woke up to this email and just was like, wow. And I just sat there in my bed for like a good hour just, you know, thinking about it. And, you know, I kind of suspected that maybe I would be getting that kind of email because I hadn't heard from them in enough time. But I'm happy that they did respond, because I don't like when there's no response. It makes you wonder, like, what's going on. There's a couple jobs I applied to and there's no response, no thank you for your application, but we've gone in another direction or another person. I hate that. I absolutely hate that. It doesn't take too long for you to write an email to someone or send a generic email out saying thanks, but, you know, this position is filled or something, just so that you get, take that person out of the limbo stage. So I got that email, but it was a personalized one. It wasn't generic. And I, you know, I really wanted to get this job, but I guess it just wasn't, you know, the time for me or the right position. They found someone who had a little bit more experience. And I'm fine with that. At least, you know, at least I know that I tried my best. There was nothing else that I could have done to better my chances of getting this. I gave it 110%. I actually fully prepared for this, talked to people, read up about it, really just prepared myself for, you know, for the interview process for this thing. And I just didn't have enough experience, and I can't help that. So I kind of am relieved that that's why I didn't get the job. It wasn't because of something that I did, or it was just that someone else just had more experience and that worked better for them. And that's fine. And I know, though, I have a problem with, you know, positions like that, not positions, but, you know, decisions like that where, you know, how are you going to get experience if you don't get hired somewhere? So I'm going to try to get the experience somewhere. So it's just about, you know, digesting what is said, being thankful for having the opportunity and the experience in it, and then just moving on. So for me, I took it in, I sat there with it, and I was just like, you know what, I can't do anything about this. I tried my best. At least they sent me a nice, you know, personal note, and it wasn't something generic. So it was nice to know that I was at least in consideration to get into that stage. And now it's time for me to move on. It's time for me to go back into applying mode and just keep applying until I find until I get hired, until I get that choice hire. So, and at least in my position also, I'm thankful that I live at home. I think I've said this several times. I'm thankful that I have a roof over my head, my car is paid, my insurance is paid, food is in my belly, and so I'm not in a position where it's a dire straits thing where, you know, if I don't get this job, I'm going to be homeless or none of that. At least I'm in a position where it's not, you know, a do or die situation, where I can actually really take my time, apply, you know, consult people, and not just take anything that comes at me, but take the right position for me. Especially since I truly believe that no one should be unhappy in the positions that they're in. I was unhappy with, you know, where I was career-wise in my life, and I decided to make that change. And the change doesn't happen The change doesn't happen overnight. You have to take certain steps. And it would have been nice if if I got a job immediately after, you know, a month of looking for jobs. But it doesn't always happen that way, and that's okay. I'm okay with it. I have marketable skills. I have a college degree. I have a master's degree, and I'm soon going to have a PhD. So there will always be work for me. I know I put a lot of work in, so there will always be work for me. And there will always be work for you if you put the work into it. So you always have to think about it in that kind of way. For any rejection that you receive, you take it in, you see it for what it is, and then you move on. You can't dwell. I mean, as much as I run things through my head, I've been getting a lot better at recognizing what that is. And if you feel like you're doing that, the best way to get through that, I think, is to journal it. So just write it down. Write down everything that you're feeling about this thing, so that at least everything that you are you know, going over and over and over and over in your mind about whatever situation, you get it out. So it's not in your head. And I think it makes it a lot easier for you to move on. So I had this, you know, disappointing last 2 days. But I just keep moving. And today I'm driving to New York and starting off the celebration, my birthday celebration. My birthday's on Saturday. Woohoo! So I just keep it moving. I don't have time to dwell and stress out about things that I can't control. I can only control the things that involve me, and my happiness and my stress levels. And that's what I'm doing. I'm moving on. I'm going to have a birthday party next tomorrow. Then I go to Atlantic City and for my girls, bachelorette party and for my birthday, and just have a good old time and forget about all this stuff, and then come back fresh on Monday and start applying for those jobs and looking for that next position. So I hope you guys can relate to this, or if you got anything from it. If you have any stories that you'd like to share with me, you can comment below. Please subscribe and share with your friends, and I will see you guys later. Bye.